fashion to me is an art and a science which keeps evolving every day, and I would say even every minute.
Fashion means to me, it means comfort, it means as a way to express someone, and I feel like the most important part of fashion is something that makes an individual feel good about themselves. So in November 2015, we started Postfold. 6 months before that, we met for dinner together, and we were just discussing about, you know, catching up.
And we were like, you know, Ashish, I told him that, Ashish, you know, I've been trying to get something for myself to wear to work, which is in my budget and is also the right fit and the right quality, and you know, looks luxury quality.
We realized both of us faced that common problem in India that we couldn't find really high quality clothes at an affordable price. And the next thing we knew, we were sitting with a masterji trying to learn how to measure garments and what would work, what do we not find here.
Postfold, the name, means post this. Once you wear the garment on you and you make the last adjustment or the last twitch or tweak, post that, the story of the day, of your day begins. So Postfold. The gap we are trying to fill is getting the right fit, the right quality at an affordable price. And also the versatility of clothing.
The price aspect, right? If you're going to bring out the best quality, the best craftsmanship, it also means that it's going to cost a little more. So I will never say that we are the cheapest product in the market, but I can guarantee tell you that it's the highest quality and it the lowest price you will ever find it in that quality.
So, you know, when it comes to launching our products, they have to be the latest trend, the best quality, and produce ethically. And to blur the line between all of those three, the first thing that we did was eliminate the middlemen.
We have eliminated a lot of middlemen from our product development cycle. A lot of brands would probably, you know, go to a factory and say, we want this, and you do the sourcing. What we do is we do all of the sourcing on our own, and we work with factories to build a quality product.
See, e-commerce, if we speak the number side, currently at 33 billion in India and expected to touch 100 to 150 billion by 2020, that really brings a spark in us that there is potential in the e-commerce market. And also it's the convenience that it brings to the end customer. Convenience in ordering at his fingertips, receiving the order at his doorstep.
For Postfold, the brand that we're trying to build, technology is the most important part, one of the most important part of it. The reason being that for the brand, for as I said before, we are trying to make a brand for professionals, young professionals that move at the pace. It is young people who are trying to make their career. They don't have the time. A lot of them are putting almost 12 hours a day in their work or more, and they're young, motivated. And you know, a lot of times you don't have the time to actually go out and shop, and so the ease of convenience plays a huge role into it.
See, what we see currently is that 70% of our traffic is via the mobile. So we are definitely trying to optimize and make our user experience and improving our user experience on our mobile website, but we feel as our user base keeps on growing, we do see a potential in the mobile app. So since we started, I would say year over year, we have grown at a fast pace of 60 to 70%. But yes, these are initial days, but we do see we do see ourselves on the growth path.
During our research, we found out about this cotton that was grown in the US called Supima cotton. And Supima cotton, we realized, is one of the finest quality cottons in the world. Only 3% of the world's cotton is actually worthy of being called Supima cotton, because it's only grown in that certain area. So we said we have to, you know, if quality is going to be our motto, we need to bring this here.
I would say that if you have an idea and if you believe in yourself, just don't stop anything. Nothing should stop you from going ahead and forming your company and executing your idea.
With the risk of sounding like any self-help book, I think the most important thing being an entrepreneur is, you know, the persistence. A lot of times there will be times when, you know, you go through this graph where, you know, you're feeling really good about what you're doing, and then the next day you will feel that, am I doing the right thing? Is this where I want to be? But I think going through that demon of, you know, that this is not the right path to be in, I think that's enjoying the journey and, you know, being true to your idea and true to your work is something that I think we should always keep in mind.